The Scanner Management Service training tutorial will be covering how to create an SMS package. Topics covered during this training will include what is an SMS package, how to create an SMS package using 123 scan, how to access recently created SMS packages, how to generate an SMS package report, and frequently asked questions. An SMS package is a single file which, when used with the Scanner Management Service, also known as the SMS agent, can be used to remotely manage a scanner by programming parameters and updating firmware. An SMS package is similar to a zip file and comprised of three file types: a 123 scan configuration file containing parameters, a 123 scan plugin containing scanner firmware, and a load directive file with programming details like trigger information. There are three steps to using the Scanner Management Service. Generating an SMS package is generally done in a lab and is the first step of the three-step process. Now let's use 123 scan to generate an SMS package. Previously generated packages can be accessed from recent files, also from the Actions menu. To create a new SMS package, click on this button, and the SMS package wizard is launched. From the Name and Notes screen, you have access to an SMS overview, a definition of an SMS package, a deployment checklist, and how-to videos like the one you're watching. First, you'll want to name your package. Second, you select the device you want to manage. For device group 1, you select the supported scanner, in this case the DS9808. Then you pick the plugin. If you notice, as I hover over these different plugins, it tells you the supported model, so you can look at your scanner and see if this is the appropriate model. This is the SR, or the standard range model, plugin. Next, you'll be asked to select your management communication protocol. The fastest programming mode is already selected by default. In this case, it happens to be Snappy. If you'd like to learn more about this setting, click the What is this? The next step in setting up your device group is deciding if you want to load parameters to your scanner. If you do, click this button and then pick your configuration file that you previously created in 123 scan. As the final step of configuring your device group, you're asked if you'd like to update the firmware of your fleet of scanners. To do that, put a check mark here and decide which version of firmware you'd like to settle in on. The most recent firmware is always listed at the top. Then you're given the option to add another device group. You can select up to 5 different model scanners or 5 different device groups within one SMS package. For debugging purposes, the Scanner Management Service allows you to track events with a log file. 2 log file options exist. Click What is this for the details on them. If you'd like to copy it to a Word document, hit copy and then paste it into a Word document and you can retain it for later use. In this case, we're going to default to a circular log file. You can also enable log file events for all device groups or by particular device groups. And fourth, on the activation trigger screen, you're given the choice of the Scanner Management Service operation mode. Click What is this for more details. 2 modes exist: run as a service or run as an application. Run as a service is the default setting. If you change it from run as a service, you'll notice that certain options are selected here to run as an application. Your set of choices changes for your event triggering option. The SMS operation mode is a choice between whether the Scanner Management Service will operate as a service and always be accessible and running in the background, or if you want it to run as an application, in which case a third-party console-initiated command or a third-party application-initiated command can launch the Scanner Management Service, and upon completion of the task defined in the package, the Scanner Management Service will terminate operation and release the USB driver. The supported SMS functionality also varies whether it runs as a service or as an application. If it runs as a service, all the capability of the Scanner Management Service is supported. You can do parameter configuration, firmware update, and asset tracking. If you run the Scanner Management Service as an application, you can do parameter configuration and firmware update, but you can't do asset tracking. In addition, support for third-party drivers is supported if you run the Scanner Management Service as an application. In terms of events that trigger a loading of an SMS package, there are a couple different options: start of the Scanner Management Service, powering up or a cable connection of a scanner, run immediately upon download of the Scanner Management Service package, or at a specific date and time. We've defaulted to the most commonly requested set of event triggers. For more details, click on What is this? On the Load and Print screen, the final screen within the SMS wizard, you have the option to save the SMS package to your computer, print an SMS report. This report, when printed, has all the details about your SMS package. It has the device group information in here, the supported scanner models, what management protocol you're using, what configuration file you chose, if you chose one. If you chose to update firmware, the name of the plugin and the firmware version, whether you chose to have a log file, and what your activation triggers are. And there's also a deployment checklist available. Click this button and you'll get all the instructions required for deploying an SMS package. And now to the frequently asked questions. First, how big is the memory footprint for this solution? The SMS agent requires about 3 megabytes. A typical SMS package is somewhere around 2 megabytes, so the total size for this solution is around 5 megabytes. 2, how many scanners can be configured within one SMS package? 5 scanners can be configured within one SMS package, but they cannot be the same model scanner with the same plugin. For example, you could have the DS6878SR, or standard range, and the DS6878HC, healthcare, within one package, but you couldn't have 2 DS6878SRs within one package. Third, does the SMS agent coexist with third-party applications and drivers? Yes, the Scanner Management Service can be run as an application. In application mode, it can be used with third-party applications and drivers such as a non-Zebra OPAS driver. Fourth, are all Zebra scanners supported by the Scanner Management Service? The SMS supports all Zebra scanners except the CS3000, the MT2000, the LS2208, and the LS1203. Fifth, how do I configure the same model scanner two ways within one store? To configure a model scanner two different ways requires two different SMS packages. The first SMS package will have a configuration file A, and the second SMS package will have a second configuration file B. And this concludes your training on how to create an SMS package.